Well, today we represent a series of research carried out basically by the archaeologists of high mountain areas from Autonomous University of Barcelona and the Spanish National Research Council. The series of research that have been done with the collaboration of different researchers and institutions like the University of Barcelona, this house, and the support of the National Park of Aigüestortes and Sant Maurici Lake. Our case studies and our main focus of interest are the mountain areas of northwestern Mediterranean region. And in a sense, today I present the case study of Sant Nicolau Valley. This is a glacial valley located just at the central Pyrenees area here in the northwest, in northwest Catalonia, very, very close to the central south France. This is an area conformated by basically by granodioric rocks and from the batholith of Maladeta, and this is an alpine mountain. When the altitudes used to be between 1,500 and 3,000 meters. There are the typical alpine U-shaped glaciers, glacial valleys. The historical sequence of occupation of this axial central Pyrenees region can be detected before the deglaciation finished at early Holocene time, when we can see different occupation of hunter-gatherer communities, also the south and the north of the mountain range. But in any case, these hunter-gatherer societies can be located at rock shelter sites in the axial central Pyrenees area, but basically in the bottom valley areas. But in some cases, they frequent the highlands too. In any case, these hunter-gathering occupation they hunt around the mountains, but they don't have a stable occupation in the central area. It's at the Neolithic times, at the early Neolithic times, when arrived the agro-livestock communities, when we can see that these communities, with their economy basic on cereal production and the cattle of sheep and different animals, when they stay and occupying the central Pyrenees areas during all the time. The main sites that we know at this area are located in the southern central area. A site first situated in the southern sides, at the uplands and the lowlands between 500 and 1,000 meters, but also at 1,500 meters we have important sites in big rock shelters and caves like Cova del Sardo or otras rocks. So in cases today, I'll speak about Cova del Sardo site. That's a small rock shelter, but the interesting thing is located at 1,800 meters of height and in the central side of the mountain range. Well, you know that these early Neolithic communities of the northwestern Mediterranean area arrived at this region about 7,500 years ago. And the occupation of the central area of the mountains is really early, because we have more or less the same chronologies in the sea area than in the mountains area. One interesting thing is that the idea that this population, that these communities that are living in mountains area, not only have an economy based on livestock activities, but also they have an important production of auxilial, and we can document it, the production of pigs and cows in the highlands. So, well, these Neolithic communities are relatively resilient in the area during 2,000 years, all the Neolithic time, but at the end of this period, in this interval between 3.3 and 2.5 kilodias before Christ, we detect an important change, social change in the management of these areas, because we can observe the presence or the frequent rock shelter sites in the higher site at 2,000 meters or 2,400 meters. Well, the methodology for study these areas include the excavation, the archaeological excavation of sites, but also we are very interested in the core sites from lakes and pit books, when we can observe the paleolandscape reconstruction using a multi-proxy. But also we have done a series of test pieces in the off-site, in the surrounding area of the archaeological sites, in order to detect how these Neolithic communities manage the landscape around the settlements. This is a new archaeo-environmental approach that wants to integrate all paleoeconomical data from both archaeological sites and environmental records. One of the mainly practice that manage the landscape is the use of fire. These Neolithic communities can use the fire for open the thick forest that we can see at the bottom valley areas and mountains. They're really close forests, and they used to fire it for manage grasslands and farmland also. This ancient firing can be detected using the core samples on lakes or pit books, but also the test pit in the surrounding areas of the settlements. This archaic deposit can be used for see the changes also in the forest, in the type of taxa, and in the landscape. We have done four different cores in lakes in all the valley and the valleys closer to them, and a series of test pieces. Well, this is the National Park of Aigüestortes and Sant Nicolau Valley, and we can see all series of archaeological sites. We have different sites excavated in the bottom valley areas, like Cova del Sardo, and also in the glacial circus in the highlands. The chronological sequence of the occupation of these sites start at, well, with only three frequent sites in Mesolithic times, a series of two sites with early and mid-Neolithic occupation, and eight different archaeological sites from this period, that I say Chalcolithic, from 3,300 and 2,500 years BC, when we have the most important present of prehistoric occupation in the valley. It increased really in 3000 and 300 years BC. That is the chronology of the Iceman Oxy from the Alps. Is when we detect a social change in the manage of these areas. Well, this is the different site, but this is the site of Cova del Sardo, located at the Baton Valley area, when there is a series of fire structures that have been analyzed by carpology and anthropology data, and we can see the short presence of cereal cultivated like Triticum, Durum, and Ordeum. Also in this site of Axial Central Pyrenees. And if we have a look to the anthropology data of the different levels of this site, we can see there was a primary forest, and then in the earliest levels we have a secondary forest. There is an impact on the taxa of wood that people use for fire in the site. For example, this impact can be detected at the 5th millennia ago, and later at this chronology of 3,300 years BC is when the human impact is strong. If we look at the phytoliths analysis of the different structures in the site, we can see in these Neolithic times, at the Mid-Holocene, there is a presence of thermomesophilous grass taxa that actually there aren't represented in the present time. So we can see the species represented, the taxa represented, different. Also in pollen analysis we can see something similar. And if we have a look to the diatoms and crassophytes analyzed in the lakes of the valley, the modelization of the temperatures for summer for this mid-Holocene time, that is in the early Neolithic, is really, really different. So we have temperatures higher in this optimum climatic of the mid-Holocene. Another data series are collected from one test pit done at the off-site, but a series of analysis, and we can see that organic matter is important in a level that we can date, that we are dating in 7,000 years ago, exactly when start the first early Neolithic occupation in the valley. At this level, if we have a look to the micromorphological analysis, we can see the formation of a paleosol when there is an important presence of sedimentary charcoal in a fluvial soil. We are in the Baton Valley area, near to a riverside. We have an important presence of phosphorus in the sediment that could be indicating manuring activities in summer, we suppose, or autumn, when there is snow less the Baton Valley. Also, we have a series of pollen data that are indicating that in this early Neolithic occupation, we have an important change in the landscape. The first human impact can be detected at the early time, at around 5000 BC, but there is another one, maybe stronger, at the late Neolithic time, that we can dating around 3.3 BC, this moment of change. Well, I'm finishing. Well, another very interesting data from pollen analysis is the presence of Cerealia taxa in both events, early Neolithic and in late Neolithic time. If we had a comparison between the pollen data from the archaeological site and the pollen data from the test pit of the off-site, we can correlationate both and observe that the arborian taxa in the surrounding area of the site is decreased. So we think that there is a grassland management in the surrounding area of the settlements. Well, the idea of these methodologies for understand how the human societies develop and their economical system, we have to study not only the data from the sites, but also the paleoenvironmental data, not only for the course from the lakes, but also using test pits. Yeah, final remark, I can see if we have a look to all the different core sampling and we see the sedimentary charcoals, we can observe these two events of impact in different sites of the central Pyrenees area that we can date at these two moments, early Neolithic and late Neolithic. But also this another one at the Bronze Age. Thank you very much.